In this video, we'll be taking a quick look at adding a custom form and/or label size in eForms. Adding custom form and label sizes is as simple as adding a page dimension declaration to the eForms config user XML file. The eForms config user XML file is found in the Minisoft eForms 6 folder, and to add a page dimension declaration, you can copy and paste the page dimension declaration on our support wiki. It's in the support entry custom form and label sizes. If you search that on support.minisoft.com, it'll come up and you'll see that there's a sample declaration. Another way of doing this, and just to show you the other method, is to open the eForms config XML file, which I have currently open here on the screen, and that is also in the Minisoft eForms 6 folder. And if I go ahead and scroll down, we'll see a number of these page dimensions, and I just want to select one and copy it. So we'll left click and drag, Control C, and we will X out of the eForms config. We don't need that anymore. And now that I have the eForms config user open here, and we'll just go ahead and paste the page dimension declaration, and go ahead and save that for now. And so we'll see here first that there's a name, and this is arbitrary, but it's important for descriptive purposes. It's 2.5 by 8 label. I want to change this to 1.75, and it's width by height. So this is 1.75 inches by, let's make it 2.25 inches. This is going to be a real small label here. The PCL number, this refers to a PCL escape code. The number 1 is for executive, number 2 is letter, 3 legal, and so on. It's not really all that important. Letter is going to be the most common thing you're printing, but with labels, it's less of an issue, so we're not going to edit that. Portrait A, this is the physical page width. It lines up also with landscape A, so there's portrait and there's landscape. The landscape A is, of course, going to be physical page width along with portrait A. Portrait B and landscape B, that's physical page height. And there's also a portrait C and landscape C, that's logical page width. Portrait D and landscape D are logical page height. There are a few other declarations here that I'm not going to edit because I don't need to. E, F, G, and H. You can read more about them and all of these fields for this page dimension declaration on that support wiki entry, custom form and label sizes. But just to show you how it would work, we'll go ahead and edit this and make it a 1.75 by 2.25 inch label. So we have our number in inches. We need to convert that to decipoints. And if you're using centimeters, please convert that to inches first before you convert it to decipoints. And to convert inches to decipoints, all you would do is you would take your height or width in inches and multiply it by 720. So I'm going to take 1.75 inches, multiply that by 720, and that will give me 1,260 decipoints. So I want to take portrait A here, and I'm going to change that to 1,260. And I'm going to take this number and copy it, and I'm going to paste it in the other appropriate areas. So the other appropriate area would be portrait C, and the reason for that is, of course, because that is the logical page width, and 1,260 decipoints is my width. And I'm also going to take that same number, if I keep scrolling down, and I'm going to put it on landscape B. Landscape B is the physical page height, but when we're landscape printing, things are flipped around. And then, of course, landscape D, because again, even though that's logical page height, when you're printing landscape, it's flipped around. So we'll put our width there in the appropriate places. Another way of doing that, if that confuses you, is just look at the numbers that you have created. For example, 5,760, just match up and paste over that the height, and for the width, the number before was 1,800, if I just paste over that. So that's another way of doing it, but we're just going through it as most detailed way as possible. So now what I want to do is I want to get the height value for 2.25, and that's 1,620. So we'll go ahead and put 1,620 here on portrait B. That's our physical page height. I'm going to go ahead and copy that. And we're going to go over, and again, see portrait D, 5,760. Wherever you find that number, just paste 1620. That's an easy way of doing it. But again, portrait D is the logical page height, so that's why we're pasting it there. We're also going to place it on landscape A, because again, things are flipped around with landscape, so even though landscape A is the physical page width, it's flipped around. And again, this final 5,760 number, landscape C, that of course is referring to our logical page width, flipped around in landscape, we'll paste that there. So we have everything in order. We'll go ahead and save it. And you can do this again, and if you just want to make another one real quickly, you can copy this. And let's go ahead and just paste it right quick. And you can edit it again, but we'll go ahead and delete that for now. We don't need to add another one. So we'll go ahead and save, and then we're going to open up the eForms Composer and see that custom form size. So we have the Composer open, and what I'm going to do is just create a new project by selecting File, New Project. Go ahead and add a page. Select OK there. Right-click the page and select Add Form. And we'll go ahead and select Blank. And here, we see in the Form Properties, there's a Page Size drop-down. And if we select that and we scroll down, we'll see that we have a 1.75 by 225 label. That's the label that we created. We'll select that, see what it looks like, and select OK. And I'm going to right-click and select Display Form and Data. We'll go ahead and just select Test Data for now. Select OK. And there it is. That's what the label looks like. So we have successfully created a custom label size in eForms.